I want to use this opportunity to speak to you a little bit about the summer I just had in Tanzania over the months of July and August. This was on the IAESTE student exchange program, where I was working in a hospital in Dar es Salaam in Tanzania. This was a phenomenal opportunity and experience that was thankfully made possible due to the guys in Go Global who successfully offered me a scholarship fund, and as I said, made this program possible for me. As you'd expect with any African country, Tanzania was really like no other. It was the most culturally rich place I've ever been to in my whole life. The people, the food, the climate, the environment, everything was just phenomenal about the experience. I was a little bit sheepish initially coming out because I was going to be just traveling by myself, and it did mean that I was going to have to really put myself out there and trust in absolute strangers. But I was extremely fortunate to go to a country like Tanzania and recognize and identify how giving and how grateful and how appreciative people are in this wonderful place. I think a perfect little story from this is when I first arrived in Tanzania, I had just arranged my visa in the airport, and it was about 3 or 4 o'clock in the morning, and there was supposed to be a lift arranged for me to drop me to my new accommodation, which unfortunately wasn't there. And it was a stage where I had kind of decided to myself, was I going to get frustrated and annoyed and feel let down by this, or was I just going to go with the flow? And that's kind of that was the sort of the motto or the mantra that I decided to kind of live by when I was in Tanzania over the summer. And as I said about the generosity of absolute strangers, this random fella came and he saw that I was in a little bit of bother and trouble, and he decided to get in contact and touch with the campus services. And before I knew it, I was being actually dropped by this guy to where I was going. And we ended up sparking up a very, very good friendship and relationship and bond. And he ended up becoming a very good friend of mine then over my summer in Tanzania. So I was massively fortunate in that regard. The one thing about the local language is that they have, so Swahili is the local language that they have there, and it's a beautiful dialect. It's many, many years old, but it actually reminded me a little bit of the Irish language and the importance of meeting and greeting people. So you'd hear obviously during the summer you'd pick up words, phrases and sentences and feel as though you'd have somewhat of grasp of the language after the end of the summer. But specifically with the greeting, they'd always take time to say hello, ask how you are, you know, how's your state of health, how's this, that and the other. And it was a real sort of, again, an endearing way of being able to then get to know the Tanzanians, because the ones then who'd had very good English were also doing the exact same things in English. And again, coming back to my original point about slowing down, we're nearly too quick to get to the point, the matter of fact of things, instead of actually, you know, asking how a person is, asking how their health is, asking, you know, how their family is, before going, this is what I need, this is what I want from you, and then just part ways. There was, I suppose, a little bit of feeling at home in a completely foreign land. I feel as though Tanzania is the Ireland of Africa. Cade Mila Falcher, 100,000 welcomes. I definitely got that when I came to Tanzania. And as I said, the people were just the best. One of the things that the Tanzanians take massive pride in is their... the level of peace in the country. There's never really been any conflict or strife within the country in comparison to north of them, which in Kenya has been some difficulties, and in other other western lands as well, to Tanzania. But they take massive pride in the ability to be sort of very welcoming and friendly, and in particular that buzzword, as I said, for being very, very peaceful. And this was, again, a very, very welcoming and homely experience that it was a very welcoming thing that I experienced. So as I said, I was working in Muibili University Hospital, which is probably the main hospital within the whole of Tanzania. So you get a very good cross section of the Tanzanian population and society, and you see people from every walk of life. You have, you know, the average Josop who's living in the city center to one of maybe the Maasai tribe who are coming from the very western parts of Tanzania with their child who's presenting very, very late with a childhood cancer. One of the really privileged opportunities that I got when I was in Tanzania was to become friendly with a girl who works in a cancer home that they have, where the parents and kids who are suffering from cancer stay during their time within the hospital. And it allowed me the opportunity to visit this home every single day and really put things into perspective for me, seeing these kids who didn't really understand, you know, hardship or suffering or pain, and were still able to smile through the pain. And just for myself, if I felt as though I was ever having a difficult or tough time, or if I was ever feeling homesick, going to this home and playing with the kids really put everything into perspective. And again, I can't be more thankful to the opportunity that I've got, and the people who have invested in me to give me and allow me this opportunity. It's certainly progressed me as a person. And I think I hope to be able to bring this into my future experiences within the hospital in Ireland and the UK.